que tu es tellement fou. Tais-toi, mon cœur perdu. Je n'ai plus rien qu'un seul désir. Laissez mon rêve d'amour partir. Viens, mon petit bateau, flotte comme
all the things you do and say. Come draw with me, let's animate your way. Come draw with me, let's do a storyboard. In La La Land, they can lend a hand from the concept to the score. So come draw with me, let's animate some more. We're at the Oscars, where the air is rarefied. We'll just glide, starry-eyed. But who needs those Oscars? We don't do this for awards. Rest assured, the creative act is its own reward. Wives, who cares, we're all inside. From the texture guys to the effects supervisor and a renderer named Shade, we're all cooped up here, but we're out good cheer. This ain't work, we're paid to play. So come draw with me, let's animate away.
Hot. I've been told I'll keep this to 2 minutes, okay? I have 2 minutes to say this, okay? So on behalf of Animation Ireland and the Irish Animation Awards Committee, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank everybody for coming and the interest they've shown since we aired this idea back in November. The committee's first meeting was held in November, as I said, and it's a credit to Maeve and the team to see a full house. It really is, so I'd like to just thank them. They've been amazing, absolutely amazing. Well, many of the companies here tonight are like tipping the 15 to 20 year mark and beyond. Animation Ireland actually started the CEO Forum back in 2006, supported by Enterprise Ireland, so thanks to Eileen for that. There have been five chairs in that time, and during that period, much has been achieved, especially through recessionary times. You only have to look at the Animation Ireland booklet, or the Animation Dingle booklet, for that matter, the depth of talent and wide variety of projects, many of them household names, both internationally and at home. In the last 3 months, Animation Ireland has taken on more of a corporate structure. The industry grows, so should the acting body, which stands in front and safeguards the interests of its members, which is very important. While the sector has certainly grown, success is there to be seen, there's no question. It is important that we maintain this growth, and it's through increased funding, and so every good idea and every studio who nurtures those good ideas can push on, bringing new business and opportunities for up-and-coming writers, directors, designers, and animators, whilst growing the IP wealth of this industry. It's all good. With the combined effort, coupled with the new tax credits, the future is looking very bright indeed, and tonight is just testament to that. So I'd like to just throw my hat out there and make that bold statement, because it's really positive. As our main sponsor, I'd like to thank the Irish Film Board for the tremendous support. Thanks, James, for your support. Events like this and the organisation and the funding and wouldn't be possible without the support of the Film Board, so thank you very much. I'd also like to please show your appreciation for Morris Galway. Where's Morris? Stand up, sir. Where are you? There he is. Morris is just an amazing guy, does great work, and his team at the Dingle International Film Festival have done a great job. I'd also like to show your appreciation for Jam Media and the Animation Dingle Committee. So, for helping us plan and be part of this wonderful event. So thanks, guys. It's been amazing. I'd also like to thank the judges for doing such a great job. You were awesome at such short notice. So I'd like to put your hands together for those guys. It's been great. And all our UK friends who made the trip, it's really good to have you guys here. It really helps build what we're trying to do here. We're delighted to have you, so thank you very much. I'd like to offer our thanks as well to Graham, the hotel manager, Sheila and Breed in reservations. Thanks again for being superb hosts. So thanks, guys. And Evan McNamara for designing an amazing award, I have to be said, from Paper Panther. Evan, thank you. And not forgetting my wife, Heidi German, for designing an amazing website. Thank you, Heidi. My 2 minutes is nearly up now, so I'm going to get off, believe me. Once again, I'd like to thank the Irish Animation Awards Committee. Thanks so much for an amazing effort. You did a great job. And finally, I have a little surprise for two very special people. Without these two people, this award would have not happened, believe me. Text half 8, 9 and 10 o'clock at night. Emails continuously is what needs to happen to make an award like this come together in a very short space of time. So I'd like to invite Maeve Tamaghi and Keith Navrati up to the stage to accept the award. This is a little surprise, so this wasn't in the agenda, it wasn't in the schedule, so guys, you've been awesome. I have to just say that, because awards like this don't happen. These guys have been amazing. I just wanted to, you know, show that tonight. Magical bag. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
It's lovely to be here for the first Animation Awards, and it's lovely to be up here presenting the first award. It's the preschool series award, the preschool animated series. So I'll start again. The preschool animated series is one of the most competitive in the global animation arena. In the past 10 years, Ireland has produced a wealth of animation in this category, and the sector is punching well above its weight internationally, with an extensive library of series from the many companies in the sector, and it's set to grow much bigger in the future, as evidenced today. So, the nominees for Best Animated Preschool Series are Bing from Brown Bag Films and Akamar Films, Henry Huggle Monster from Brown Bag Films, and Lily's Driftwood Bay from 16 South. So let's have a look at clips from those. Yeah.
and the hero monsters hit the road in search of their next awesome adventure, the end.
And the winner is Henry Hugglemonster from Down Bad Fairies.
This is so exciting. Thank you so much. I guess just personally, I want to thank or say how appreciative I am to even be included in this amazing, talented Irish animation scene and industry. You guys are awesome, and I'm thrilled to be part of it. You might not get this from my accent, but Henry Hugglemonster is almost a totally Irish-born and bred project from Brown Bag Films, who found the book from Walker Film, Walker Books, mm-hmm. and of the Irish Film Board, who helped evolve it and develop it, and the one and only Niamh Sharkey, who had created the book in the first place, and all the great people at Brown Bag Films bring it to life. Niamh, would you?
Yeah. Oh, thank you. It's absolute joy, like, to get to win something for Henry Hugglemonster, and as Norton was saying, we made it in Brown Bag Films, and I just want to thank all of the guys in Brown Bag Films, Cahill and Doc, who nurtured it right from the beginning, loved the book and loved the characters. And Helen is here tonight, which is really nice, from Walker Books. So it's something that we've all made together, and we couldn't have done it without the absolutely amazing team in Brown Bag Films. Brona, the art director, Norton, who directs it, who always gives the credit to everybody else, but he's great. And it's just, it's been such a joy to make it. And I just want to say personal thanks to Shane. This episode that we were shortlisted for, we got all the kids in the studio to design the characters, which is really, really fun. We got them all in and they designed the characters. So we mixed like 2D with 3D. And it was great that Disney let us do that as well. And Shane, it was the first episode that he directed. So I just want to thank you all. It's really cool. And maybe Shane, do you want to thank your mommy?
Thanks, Mom.
Ladies and gentlemen, Christopher Walken!
Wow! Who'd have thunk it? So many animators in one room. Incredible, on this tiny peninsula that is guarded by a dolphin. I gotta say, I wanted to say he was a fun guy, but it didn't turn out that way. See, I went for a so-called therapeutic swim with your fungi. At first, it was fine. Everything went swimmingly. But after a while, he just turned on me. The guy turned nasty. I had to whoop his dolphin ass, which kind of defeated the purpose. Yeah, I put him down. All right. I had to give him a hole in the head because I already got one. Anyway, time's a waste, and I wish I couldn't remember where I kept that watch. Before I introduce a very lovely lady, I want to just plug my app. I have a driving with Walken app out at the moment. It's kind of a sat nav thing, so we might have an audio clip of it.
In 20 minutes, turn left. Whoa, what part of left didn't you understand, asshole? Now I gotta recalculate.
Okay, it's on the App Store if you want to buy it. So, ladies and gentlemen, this gal, when you see her, you're gonna say, what a gal. She's from Washington, D.C. No, sorry, CBBC. Sarah Moore, ladies and gentlemen.
I've so wanted to do this. So So, I'm here to present the award for the best animated short. I'd like to think that animated shorts are a wonderful medium for new, emerging and established directors alike. They require focused storytelling, innovation, skill, all the while working within a much tighter framework than their feature animation or TV series counterparts. The nominees for Best Animated Short are Deadly from Cavalier, Fresh Cut Grass from Boulder Media, and Macropolis from Flickr-Pix.
It was a joy to work with them. Thanks to my wife, Arlie. Thanks especially to my producer on this, Shannon, who can't be here tonight, but she was great support. And everyone probably in this room knows that these short films are really kind of a labor of love. And it's really nice to be kind of recognized because they're just sort of little things that kind of potentially even suck resources from the studio and various other kind of things. But, but it's really it's lovely too that we can make them. It's lovely that the Frameworks project exists, and thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Dustin Hoffman.
Wow. You know, it's so weird this being in a country where you're not the most famous Dustin. You know, it's a good thing we can't get mixed up because he's like a little guy with a big beak. So, it's great to be here in the west of Ireland because, it makes me feel very romantic. I feel like sharing with you, I've been in love with the same woman for over 40 years. If my wife ever finds out, she'll come back. People often ask me, what's the secret of a good marriage? And our secret is, we decided right from the start that I would make all the major decisions and she would make the minor ones. And what do you know, after 40 years, we've never had to make a major decision. We still hold hands all the time. If I let go, she starts shopping. Someone stole our credit cards. I'm not reporting it, they're actually spending less than she does. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to introduce a man who's, I'm proud to call a dear friend, even more so now that he's paid me a lot of money to say that. Ladies and gentlemen, from Nickelodeon, Jim Patterson.
Good evening, everyone. It's a complete honor to be here. So I'm here to present the Best International Short. The International Animated Short is an opportunity for directors to compete with their international counterparts and be recognized by a global audience. It's wonderful to reach out and acknowledge the fantastic talents of our international counterparts tonight. The nominees for Best International Short are Bait by Dane Wynn. Chasing Sunlight by Andrea Kwan. And Outlines by Daisy Gould.
Is unimaginably huge, but the distance between them is even more incredible. Each one is millions and millions of miles apart.
And the winner is Outlines by Daisy Gould.
They're a charity who support loads of emerging artists and general things like that. And so they have a page, support to save Ideas Tap. So everyone go on there, help save Ideas Tap, because without them, this film would still just be an idea and not have happened at all. So thank you so much.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the starters! Yay! See you after them. Two-time Emmy Award-winning writer, Mark Flanagan, ladies and gentlemen!
Yeah, it's me.
Good evening. Now, this is a very cool-looking award, I'll say. Much cooler than Emmys. I'm delighted to be here at the Dingle Festival again. I think it's my sixth or seventh time. Thank you, Morris, for inviting us. And I am here to present the award for the Best Writer or Writers Preschool Series. And my connection to, and I'm also delighted to be here at the Irish Animation Awards, the first ever, the premiere. I had to look, but I wanted to get it exactly right. My connection to animation is that I was on a television show in the United States, and the called the Tracy Ullman Show, and the segments, the tiny segments in the Tracy Ullman Show was developed and written and produced by Matt Groening, who went on to do The Simpsons, which apparently is still on the air. So I'm proud to have been connected to that institution, as it is. When my daughter was 3 or 4 years old, my daughter Tara, she said to me, "You know, Dad," I said, "Yes, Tara." She said, "You know, Dad, when I grow up, it's going to be the future." And that's the sort of out-of-the-box thinking that preschoolers are into. And so the nominees have harnessed that very particular preschool sense of wonder and so writing for preschool and is a specialized skill because they have to communicate the stories and ideas and present characters in a really fun and unique way that will engage these 2 to 6 year olds. As any parent of young children will tell you, that's not an easy task. I once, when my daughter was in cooperative preschool, I would go in and help on 1 or 2 days a week. And I remember once saying to a young man named 4 or 5 year old, named Sasha, who seemed sort of preoccupied with something, and I said, "Now, Sasha, I think perhaps you want to go to visit the bathroom." And he said, "No." I said, "Are you sure you don't want to go to the bathroom? Because you see him, you're shaking your leg, and you sure?" And he said, "You know, I'm the boss of my own doo-doos." And with that charming anecdote, the nominees for Best Writer or Writers for Preschool Series are the writing team of 16 South for Lily's Driftwood Bay. Jason Tamamadi, I hope I pronounced that correctly, for Planet Cosmo, a Geronimo production. And also from Geronimo Productions, Andrew Brenner for Punky. And the winner is Punky. Andrew Brenner, come on up.
Thank you so much. It's an honour to be here at the first animation, Irish Animation Awards. I'm really pleased. I'd like to thank Gerard O'Rourke for giving me the opportunity of working on Punky, which was a wonderful project to be to get the chance to work on, and felt like a special responsibility taking on this kind of subject matter, having Down syndrome main character. We had a great team, and I'd like to thank Jason Tamamagi for his script editing and notes, which were brilliant. And I'd also like to thank Amy, who voiced Punky. One of my biggest honors was when I arrived at one of the recording sessions and she just said, "Is my writer here?" So thank you very much for this, and thanks everybody.
Is that Maddie? Alan Rickman! Shut up. When I was first asked to appear in this insignificant outcrop, many years ago, I think it was your version of the BAFTAs, the BIFTAs or something, ishes, whatever, I said no, because it was beneath me. But my good friend, who's since passed on, Nelson Mandela, God rest his soul, he said to me, "Russia the reconsider. Ireland is a beacon of Latin hope, a land of reconciliation. Please, Ireland, reconsider." I said, "Shut up, Nelson. Who asked you?" In the light of subsequent events, I regret my curtness. But as it is, this is on my way to Hollywood, so I thought I'd stop off and grace all you little animators with my presence. And do you know what? I'm so glad I did. Because it really is beneath me. I was right, and it's always nice to be proven right. Just before I introduce next act, I'd like to plug my autobiography, which isn't selling very well, story of my life. Save your time. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, from Walker, Helen McAleer!
Now, so listen, as publishers, we know that great storytelling is at the heart of great entertainment. This obviously extends to writing for the world of the animation series and indeed provides the very foundation for the animation to be built upon. So the nominees for Best Writer of an Animated Series are Colm Tobin and Aidan O'Donovan for Brain Freeze, Great Entertainment. Trevor J. Colgan for Roy, Jam Media. And Mark Hodgkinson for Roy, Jam Media.
Can you just kind of touch us here? Will you please hurry up and tell us where the deepest part of the ocean is?
That means it's time for...
The Dice Pay
Awesome! Hey, Carson.
Remember what I said about the questions?
Sorry. It's okay, Mr. Lucy. And yes, I'm a cartoon. But don't worry. It might look a little different, but I'm just like all of you. What do you mean, Lauren? What time is it? What's going on?
This, son, is your mortal enemy. Now, I want you to spend 30 minutes every day staring into his eyes, visualizing his defeat and destruction.
Destruction?
Is Trevor J. Colton.
Yeah!
Oh, well, I was talking to my fiance Lena, who is a script editor. We were discussing, we were watching the Oscars last week, or a couple of weeks ago, and I was saying that I think they all know who wins. Look at all of them. They knew they didn't win. Like, you know? So it's a great surprise. Thank you so much. I'd like to thank everyone at Jam Media and everyone at CBBC. It's such a pleasure. It's such a pleasure to work in children's TV. I just think it's very inspiring to be around the people who work in the industry. It's a great collaborative process, it really is. And you're around so many talented people who are so enthusiastic about what they're doing, and it inspires you to do really good work. And thank you so much. And
Hoo-ha! Come to the land of saints and scholars. That's what they told me. Saints and fucking scholars. What was the first place they brought me? Temple Bar. Temple fucking Bar. That was the first place we went. What was the first smell that greeted my nose? Was it the scent of a woman? No. Was it the aroma of the Guinness Brewery? No. It was vomit, ladies and gentlemen. Temple Bath. That's what they should call it. To get away from the smell, I went to the Wax Museum. Wax. Looking for the little Al Pacino statue that they had there. Every city has a good one. Or a mediocre one. Every city has one except fucking Dublin. No Al Pacino statue, Dublin. Get it together. Dingle? You're doing okay, you got the real thing here. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce to you, from Bell Laboratories, Eileen Enterprise. No, that's not right. From Enterprise Ireland, Eileen Bell, ladies and gentlemen!
I'm delighted to announce the best animation for apps and gaming. As the lines within the industries blur and boundaries disappear, animation has a huge significance within the apps and gaming industries. The quality of animation in this medium further immerses and enhances the user experience. The nominees for best animation apps and gaming are Dino Dog, A Digging Adventure with Dinosaurs by Story Toys. Five Fables by Flickr Pix. Ship Antics, The Legend of the Kiki Beast by Studio Antics, the legend of the
honor. Thank you very much.
I'd like to first acknowledge the other nominees, Giant and Flickrpix, because we were checking out the apps and they're awesome. So the competition was great. Thank you very much. We're honoured to win. Stephen Kelly, who had a big part to play in the animation, didn't make it tonight, so I want to thank him or acknowledge him as well. But I want to acknowledge especially Adam also, but this fella here, because he created Shibantix, so I'm going to let Owen take the podium.
Thank you. This is just a fantastic award to win, especially here in Dingle. I just grew up outside Tralee, so this is just such a fantastic award. against the competition that we had tonight, it's even more special. So thank you to the IAA and have a great night. Thank you.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, as Batman's mom used to say, it's time for our dinner. So we'll see you after dinner.
Give the Murakami Award for 2015. It is, first of all, I have to say that all of you I know remember Jimmy Murakami in various ways. He was one of those wonderful, wonderful men. He had this kind of calmness, this Zen-like inspiration which he had. He was a great, great animator, wonderful films that he made. He came to Ireland many, many years ago in the early 1970s, and I first met him when he set up, assisted Fred Wolf in setting up Murakami Wolf in Dublin in the late 1980s, in that wonderful period when there were people like Don Bluth and Murakami Wolf, that wonderful phase of Irish animation which went on right through the late 1980s and into the 1990s. And I think many people in animation now still owe their origins to that very, very extraordinary period in the history of Irish animation. And Jimmy was there as an inspiration, as somebody helping all that to happen. So it is with great fondness that I remember Jimmy, and it is with great sadness that we all saw his passing last year. I thought one of the most wonderful aspects of the Academy Awards this year, and I'm going to come to the Academy Awards this year, because one of those moments when Jimmy's face came up amongst those who had passed away, I thought that was a tremendous moment. The fact that he was remembered and honoured in that way internationally around the world, I thought was a wonderful, wonderfully moving thing. But he was truly at heart in an Irishman in terms of his the work he did here, the time he spent here. He was a most wonderful person. But coming back to the Academy Awards for this year, and this ultimately has to be said to have been a wonderful, wonderful year, and we're only in March so far, for Irish animation. I mean, to absolutely have been able to see Song of the Sea up there nominated as one of the Shaun of the Sea was one of the 5 best animation feature films in the world. And I don't care what anybody says. Absolutely. Somebody's going to have to start playing the music or I'll keep talking about Shaun of the Sea. It is just such a wonderful, wonderful piece of work. It is the most magnificent Irish animation feature film that has been made so far. And that comes from a company that made The Secret of Kells and all the other wonderful animation work that Cartoon Saloon has done. And I think it is absolutely a tribute to the, let's call them, the lads from Kilkenny. And at this stage, all the work that they've done. And lasses from Kilkenny. The great success of this Cartoon Saloon. I was talking to Paul Young there about trying to remember when we met first, because I had the great privilege and pleasure of working with Cartoon Saloon from the very earliest stages when I was practicing as a lawyer. And I mean, it was The Secret of Kells in particular was a long, long saga of putting a package together, but it was such a pleasure and a privilege to see the great work in the end. But now we're here in 2015, and I think it is ultimately a celebration of Irish animation at its very, very best with Song of the Sea, which was, as I say, one of the nominated Academy Award feature films, animated feature films for this year's Oscars. And I know it didn't win, but that's not the point. The point is, it was nominated, and we were so pleased and proud of everybody involved, and in particular, the individual who tonight is the recipient of the Murakami Award for 2015. The recipient for this year is Tom Moore.
They couldn't move anymore with all the paint and stuff that had been encrusted on, so it was a very nice way to start your career, kind of standing on the shoulders of people who had gone before, so it was fantastic. And people are talking to me on Twitter, right? Shouldn't write your notes on your phone. See, old school, you know, 2D, use paper, that's it. You shouldn't have gone CG with my speech. we've got to know Jimmy a little bit in the later years of his career as well, which is fantastic. And I was lucky enough to spend a bit of time with him, and he's a really fantastic guy. And his films, as amazing and all as they were, he himself was just an amazing guy, an amazing storyteller, such a warm guy. So it was a real honour to get Jimmy, an award named after Jimmy. I just want to say a big thanks to Morris, to Maeve, everyone at Jam Media, all the Animation Ireland people. I think that Paul Young is involved somewhere in Animation Ireland. I just want to say a big thanks to Animation Dingle. I think it's a fantastic event. I think these awards, you have to come up with something to call them. Or the Ayaz or something. I won an Ayaz. I'd love to win an Ayaz.
Eon.
What? Eon.
Eon. I won one! It's really thank all my comrades and partners today. You've been amazing partners. It's just fantastic to go into work every day and be inspired by all the talent that's around me every day. So it's really fantastic to kind of accept the award pretty much on their behalf. And I just think this is a fantastic event. I know it's going to go from strength to strength. I think it's just brilliant, isn't it? Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, he's got the perfect face for radio, George Hook!
Well, how are you, lad? You know, when I was getting on my cycles here, by the way. Cycle here because I'm trying to get fit. It's a two-stage process. First stage was to get fat. I achieved that. I'm on to stage two. And I have this thing for big tits. I only need it when I'm running. It stops them flapping around. Sports bra. Yeah, that's it. So I was getting on the bike, and the lovely Ingrid says to me, George, what the heck are you trying to do? Give yourself a heart attack cycling down to Dingle. I says to her, Ingrid, would you shut the feck up and let me get down there? There's going to be free drink for the whole night. But I know I shouldn't slag her because she has been my rock. Ingrid has been my rock for many years, through all the bad times. All the times when things have gone wrong, Ingrid has been there. When I broke my leg, she was there. When I went bankrupt, she was there. When I crashed the car and went into a coma, she was there. All through the bad times. In fact, go to think of it, she's a fucking jinx. I'm getting a divorce. But you know I won't because, you know, I enjoy the family life. I remember when my kids were small. She brought one of the little fellas and said, will you change his nappy? I said, I'm a bit busy, Ingrid. Would you wait? I'll do the next one. A few hours later, she came back. I said, no, the next baby. I think politicians are like nappies. They should be changed regularly and for the same reasons. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, it's now my incredible pleasure to introduce to you a man from Mushku, Jason Tamalagi. Come on, Jason. Take your time. Here he is now. Reputation.
Hello. I am here to present the award for Best Design / Art Direction. And there's probably not a person in this room who doesn't know the importance of this category. It says here, design and art direction are essential to create a strong and unique aesthetic to the animated shows. They provide the backbone of visual engagement for the audience to draw them in further to these new characters and their worlds, and that's absolutely true. And it also helps things look pretty, which is good. So the nominees for best design and art direction are Bing, Brown Bag Films and Akamar Films. Doc McStuffins, Brown Bag Films. Henry Huggle Monster, Brown Bag Films. I'm just going to nip out and put a bet on Brown Bag Films. So let's watch the clips.
Gosh, people are talking from the past. Gathering to happen years ago? I think so.
That's why more ordinary things. Yeah! I'm going to find some.
Yeah, me too.
Greets away!
Hey!
Yeah.
Oh,
you gotta scramble, I gotta scramble.
in the fashion business. And the winner is...
Bro Mike! Giant! Don't eat it!
It's Bing! Steve O'Connor and Stephen Robinson, best design in our direction.
Very much a team effort. I asked the guys earlier this week, they couldn't be here unfortunately, but they would love to thank the whole team of Brown Bag. We're just, you know, just the fact that we're here on three awards tonight as nominees, it just shows we've such a talented team and we're so, so lucky to have them. Bing is co-producer with co-producer Akmar, and they're a fantastic co-producer to work with. And we just loved the work that we had to start with was Ted Duan's books, and we really feel that we just brought that to life on the show. And just also, we had a little bit of Dingle actually in Bing, because Stephen Robinson, he has a family holiday home here, and he just loved so much of the landscape in Dingle that there's specifically Dingle fuchsias in the park in Bing, if you ever see the show. So. Really
cool
that we're
going to
here tonight.
And
thanks very much to Dara and Connell for
being here. Can I just say quickly, we're going to stick earlier on when we had the panel about not enough women producers on the panel up here earlier on today. And can I just say, as amazing as our art directors are, if they weren't bent into shape by Lorraine right here, who's our producer on the show, they would never have been able to achieve the work they did. So we lost their producers.
Ladies and gentlemen, from out of the Oasis, Noel Gallagher.
Alright. How you doing, alright? I'd just like to thank Brown Bag for organising that last award. You know, it's funny, when my agent said I was going to go to Ireland to do like an animation award, I thought you'd all be cartoons. Like all bouncing around and that, bugger riding, whatever. So, it's a good surprise, they're all humans. We're very creative people, you know. A lot of people don't realise how much work goes into animation. But I think it's great what we're doing on cartoons and that. I think it's great. Quite buzzed about it. I'm a bit creative myself, you know. I've done loads of songs and that, words, music. A lot of top 10 singles, not too shabby. And I've got a 320 page book coming out. I know that because I've just finished writing the page numbers. And I've done the title and the end. Just got to fill in the rest. It's half the battle, isn't it? So, I'm going to call it City Man. It's about a Man City fan. See what I did there? City Man, Man City. Eat it, tosses. We're not the noisiest neighbours anymore. All right, the alternative title is Liam is a Prick, and that's also the alternative title for all my work. So ladies and gentlemen, now without further ado, whatever way you spell that, it's very hard work to spell a Jew. Ladies and gentlemen, from Jam Media, please put your hands together for Mr. Alan Shannon! Take it, Alan.
Thanks very much, and I'd like to accept this award very gratefully. Hang on a second. Paul Tylak, isn't he great? It's at this point where, sadly, I'm at that point in my life where I have to wear these fellas in order to read. I am 27, so these things happen at that point in your life. So here goes. I think it actually adds probably 10% extra perceived intelligence. okay? The director provides the vision. I said perceived intelligence. Sorry. The director provides the vision for the show or the series, leading their teams from beginning to the end of any given animated production, and are among the most sought after professionals in the animation industry. Hear, hear. They work hand in hand with producers and endeavour to keep the production on track, on time and on budget, all the while striving for creative excellence. And the nominees for Best Director are Nicky Phelan for Bing, Brown Bag Films. Ian Benjamin Kenny for Brain Freeze, Kite and Team. And David McCamley for Peter Rabbit, Brown Bag Films. Let's have a little sneak peek.
Welcome back. Megan just got in touch to say, will you please hurry up and tell us where the deepest part of the ocean is?
That means it's time for...
Today's Big Answer!
Emma, Bing did a pee on the floor.
Never mind, Bing. It's no big thing.
No squirrels? No squirrels?
Knock it! Run!
Come back here!
And the winner is Bing, Nicky Phelan.
I'm very happy to accept this on Nicky's behalf. I know if he was here, he'd be thanking everyone but himself, but Nicky and Jeroen were a fantastic team on Bane. Jeroen was our story director and looked after all our animatics, and Nicky is series director. I just could not have asked for a better partner on the show. He was just fantastic to work with. He's been with Brown Bag for quite some time now, and is just doing fantastic things, and we're so lucky to have him on our team. And thank you very much, Nicky, for bringing Bane to life. We just love the show, so thank you very much.
Okay, and now the people who are hosting us here at Dingle Skellig Hotel have organised something which I think is really sweet. It's dessert, ladies and gentlemen. Enjoy it, and we'll be back afterwards.
Ladies and gentlemen, one of the finest actors of his generation, Jack Nicholson.
Gentlemen, discreet me here in Ireland, land of the little people. You're not so little anymore, are you? I met a guy when I was coming out of the jacks, as we call him. He was so big I thought he was the door. I was looking for a handle. You know, there's a sign up in the toilets. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, there's a sign. A sign in your toilets. It says, please only flush toilet paper in this receptacle now. I didn't want to do it, but rules are rules, so I took a dump on the floor. Damn, you people are strict. You know, it's great to be back in Ireland. This is where I met my first wife. She didn't like me calling her that at the time. But hell, you gotta be realistic. You're dealing with Jack here. It's where I got a lot of my first jobs in my youth. In Ireland, I worked on Moore Street. Yeah, when I was a lot younger, I worked in the fruit stalls, and that's where I got the line, "You want the fruit? You can't handle the fruit!" Until you paid for it. You didn't use that bit in the movies. I also worked in a pharmacy for a while, and that's where I got the line, "Here's Johnny's." Yeah, because they just been legalized at the time, and y'all were still a bit embarrassed about it. So I had to point them out. Now, so you might have been embarrassed, but ladies and gentlemen, this next guest has never been embarrassed in his life. In fact, he sold me a couple of condoms just now at the hall. Please put your hands together for Mr. Dara O'Connell, ladies and gentlemen, from Brown Bag.
Hello, everybody, and it's really difficult to be coming on at this late hour after nobody has drank anything to this point.
Well done.
The award tonight is for the best animation. And, you know, animation, like, it's evident all around us in the wide range of media, from, you know, commercials, television programs, feature films, apps, and computer console gaming. And this category acknowledges the wide range of platforms that animation covers, but I mean, you know, lots of us in this room now are animators. I know tonight we've celebrated writing and producing and art direction and everything else, but speaking as an animator, I mean, nothing gives you that thrill from doing those first few tests and seeing something moving, and I think that's what gives us a massive thrill when it comes to animation. And tonight, the nominees are Board Gosh Networks, Tommy McInerney from Brana Bar. The Last Hijack from Toronto Bar. And Lily's Driftwood Bay. Best Animation Award goes to Board Gosh Networks, Tommy McInerney from Toronto Bar.
I think I want to quote Bing and just say, I think I wet the floor. It's really, we're really chuffed to be recognised by a community that's a huge inspiration to us, the animation community in Ireland. I mean, I think Irish animation rocks.
To reiterate what Gavin said, but also to mention a couple of guys who are not here tonight, Sam Boyes and Mary Domingos, who were massively instrumental in bringing that character to life. So I just really like to thank those guys as well. And also, you know, doing these kind of things, I mean, you guys all know this, like, there's other people who are not involved in the industry that also suffer, like, for, you know, the long hours that goes into creating these things. And I just like to mention the three ladies, Brenda Burke, Victoria Haysburg, and Julie Kelly.
you guys also helped.
Just one last thing from the producer. Thank the client. I know it's a commercial, it's from the dark side, I know, you know, I have to say, Rothko, the agency that brought it to us, they came to us last year and said, can you guys do this? And we said, of course we can, you know, so we had to go through a long, prolonged time to kind of prove that we could do it to them. It went out to pitch, it pitched in the UK. We won it against the UK opposition, which was great. Bord Gáis Networks. They're now Gas Networks Ireland, in case you haven't noticed. You know, most of the advertising people in the country say, advertising's for children. I'm glad I didn't come here today. Or animation's for children, I should say. It's not. It's great to see that clients will actually hand over money and allow companies like ourselves to take a chance and, you know, produce their advertising campaigns as animations. So thank you very much.
Pat Kelly!
Hello, a dingle. Aren't we great? So, there I was, in a pub, minding my own business. I own the pub. And I happened to see Madonna up on the television there. And I couldn't help thinking, isn't she a bit like a slinky? Not much use for anything. But you can't help smiling when you see her tumbling down the stairs. Yes, indeed. I have a tendency to put my foot in my mouth quite a lot. My wife was actually trying out some new swimwear, and she hadn't tried any for at least £10. I mean, 7 years. And she said, will I try the two-piece or the all-in-one? And I said, you better try the two-piece, because you won't get it all in one. She said, no, Pat, seriously, do I look fat? And I said, no, but, and it's a big but. I was 2 weeks in intensive care. Ladies and gentlemen, on a scholarly note, from Scholastic, David Mabry. Side of the stage from where you were. And back again.
So apparently they thought I'd be too drunk to do this at this hour. And they've written everything down.
Gotcha!
Which I'm going to follow to the letter. Music is at the heart of any great show, providing another experience to engage the audience. The opening theme tune of a show bursting from the TV is an announcement and guaranteed to bring kids running. Mark doesn't actually say which direction they were running. The nominees for Best Music and Sound Design: Lily's Driftwood Bay by 16 Cent. They should get one, right?
I know.
The Travels of the Young Marco Polo, Magpie 6 and Monster Entertainment. Woo! And Will They Looks by, well, Darren Hendry. And I love it. Thank you.
dear, 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 dear. I didn't expect this, actually, you know. Do you know, this show is a really special show, and it's a show that, it's our fifth show, but it's a show which really comes from the heart. And the whole journey to making this show has been a long journey, and you know what it's like, you know, these things don't come easy. And it's self-funded. We spent 5 years waiting before it actually hit TV, and it's everything in the show is organic. You know, everything's, you know, the show's made from 10,000 pieces of things that have been farmworked over the beach. And in trying to make the music for the show, I wanted to match that visual with the sound, and I wanted to create a soundscape and a soundtrack which was completely organic and was actually completely made from real instrumentation. So real trumpet, real session players, real everything. And well, it's a bit emotional actually. It's been quite a journey, you know, and it means so much to me, and it means so much to the rest of the team, you know, back in Belfast. It's been a labour of love. Can't say anymore. Thanks so much.
Looking for I collect, like most comedians turn actors, I collect cuckoo clocks and jack-in-the-boxes. So I went looking for something. I didn't buy any, nothing really jumped out at me. But yeah, they said there's a 70% death rate for cats up here. Now it's 75. So I love animation. I love everything about animation. I love it. My kids love it. I love my kids. And I loved animation when I was a kid. My kids love animation. I do a lot of stuff with my kids. I actually know a very useful thing with babies, to help babies go to sleep. This is an interesting fact. They love the sound of static. You know, like if you make a sound like that kind of sound, like white noise. Babies love that, and it calms them down. You know, like vacuuming or traffic or just water babbling, just start frying. And, if I pick up a baby that's crying, I just go like that. And it settles right down, goes straight to sleep. There's more than I can say for the parents who are all like, hey, how did you get in? Yeah, call the cops. Take your time. Thankfully, babies grow up into kids. I love my kids. We go camping a lot. We've just been camping there recently, and we wanted to fit in with the wilderness, so we went looking for camouflage gear. Couldn't find any. But I have to say, there's a delay on this. I have to say, camping is nature's way of feeding mosquitoes. I lost so much blood from this last trip. When I got home, I cut myself shaving. I started deflating because there was only air coming out. Okay. All right, we'll put that down to experience. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, let's bring on the Broadcasting Authority of Ireland, Kieran Kassane!
Award. Thanks very much to the organisers for asking me to come and present this award. And congratulations to Animation Ireland for the initiative to establish these awards and picking such a great venue to celebrate everything that's great in Animation Ireland. The energy in the room, I only arrived this evening, but the energy in the room is really, really palpable, and there's a real sense that everybody who has been recognised either in terms of being shortlisted or actually picking up one of these wonderful awards has really valued it. That's great to see. The next award recognises the fact that student films have long been the calling card for new and emerging talents. And the quality and innovation of these films can be astounding. And the nominees tonight, in their own way, reflect that tradition. The nominees for the best student film are Daisy Chain from IABT, Vertical Horizons from IABT, and Wounded from Ballyhale.
Thank you.
wounded from that attack.
I was chosen to protect my school from the forces of evil. I am the ninja. I am Randy Cunningham.
Unfortunately, can't be here. He became a father for the first time 2 weeks ago, so he's busy losing his mind. But he asked me to say a few thank yous. On behalf of everyone, we'd like to thank Pauline McNamara, Sally Roden, and Sheila DeCourcy at RTE Junior, Tim Lawton and Cheryl Taylor at CBBC, Alex and all the team at Ardman Rights, our international distributors, and Cathy Foley and everyone at the Science Foundation of Ireland for their continued support. Just a quick one on our own team. Thanks for everyone who worked on it to make it happen. It was brilliant working with you all. Thanks for everyone here for making all this happen. It's amazing to just even be nominated in the amount of talent that's in this room. So thanks a million. Hope to see you all again next year. This is brilliant too.
Thank you, Brain Freeze and Roisin Begley there from Dingle National School. Well, we've come to the end of the evening, ladies and gentlemen. Did you enjoy it?
Yes!
Would you do it again?
Yes!
Okay, we'll do it again another time. Okay, well, ladies and gentlemen, a few people to thank. Animation Ireland. And everyone involved in this special first Animation Awards. A big thank you to Dingle Skellig Hotel. And of course the host, the Dingle Film Festival. So ladies and gentlemen, I hope you had a great night, and it's going to get even better now. Get on your dancing shoes, because the tables are going to be moved and we're going to start dancing. So get ready for that. Good night.